Hi and welcome to another Unity tutorial. Let's have a look at how we create a timer with C# scripting. Create a new 2D project. You need a background and a font with digits. Drag the background into the scene and name it timer. Let's create the first text field. Right click, select UI and text. Let's just call it for minutes. A new canvas is created. We just have to zoom out a little bit to see it. Here we go. Let's change the text and format it. The text size could be something like 126. Let's see if yes, looks good. Now we have to change the font. Just drag the font file up to the font text field. Yeah, looks good. Now we only need the position and the color. Let's start with the position. Let's center the text. Now, it's a very good idea to have the game view in another window. Just drag the game tab a little bit to the right and create a new view. Click at the color field to change the color. We can use the pipette tool to extract the correct color from the background. Yep, looks cool. Now, let's fix the size and position. Click canvas. And not that one. Click canvas and canvas scaler and scale with screen size. Now the text will appear correct when we scale the game view. Adjust the position of the two digits. Yeah, it looks cool. Now we can just duplicate the digits and call them for seconds. Let's move the digits so they appear correctly. Looks fantastic. And we do the same again, duplicate, and this one we call it seconds 100. And let's move the digits a little bit to the right on the x-axis. Looks great. Time for some scripting. Right click, create C# script. We just call it timer. Double click on the new timer script to open Visual Studio. Let's begin the script by creating the new functions or methods for the timer. The first function could be called timer start. And don't forget, it has to be a public method. Copy the method and paste it, and we call the next method for timer stop. We copy this as well and call the last method for timer reset. Okay, to begin with, let's test these methods. And to test, we can just print something to the console window. Let's say the first text message could be just start, and the next could be just stop, and the last one could be just reset. Back in Unity, we have to create a new button. Select UI and button. We can just open it and delete the text. We just don't need that for this project. Now we have to reposition and maybe scale the button a little. And we could also make it transparent so we actually don't see the button. Let's call the button for button start, and we can just duplicate that as well. Move the new button and rename it to something like a button stop. And we just duplicate that as well. Then we move it and we call this for button reset. And we make these two buttons invisible by changing the alpha to 0. Cool. Now, let's test the result. Looks good and good and yeah, all buttons are working. Now we have to connect the timer script to the buttons. Just do that by dragging, and you select the timer and timer start for the first button. Do the same trick for the next one. Drag the timer script and select timer, timer stop. And for the last button, we again drag the timer script to the button and oops. And here we go. What? And select timer and timer reset. Now we can actually test the script. Start, stop, and reset. Everything seems to work fine. Now back in Visual Studio, we have to do a lot of scripting. First, we have to import the Unity Engine.UI. Then we have to create the variables for the text fields. We call that public text. And the first column we call for time or minutes. And the next one we just duplicate it and just call it for time or seconds. And the last one we call for time or seconds 100. The timer reset method is not that complex, so we will start with that. We just set timer minutes text equals to timer seconds dot text equals to timer seconds 100 dot text and equals to 00. And don't forget the semicolon. Back in Unity, we can now test the method. Just click reset timer and we can see all the digits go to 0. Works perfect. We should also reset the timer when the program starts. So we just up in the start method, we just add the timer reset, we just copy it here and add the timer reset to the start function. Don't forget the semicolon. Now we have to create some more variables. We call the first variable for private float start time. And we copy that and call the next one for private float stop time. And just another float, and we just call that for timer time. We also need a boolean. We call that private bool is running, and we set that to false. First, we have to calculate all the seconds that the timer has run. We call this variable for timer.time. So timer.time equals stop time plus timer.time minus start time. Semicolon. Start time and stop time has no value in it. So let's take a look at that. We go to the start method and we say if is running equals to false, and we could move the print start to inside this if statement. That's cool. And now we set the is running equals to true. So now the timer is running. And we will just copy this, and if running, then we print stop. And we set the is running is false. So now we know if the timer is running or not. Okay, let's set the start time. Start time equals time dot time. So when we press the start button, the start time will be the exact time we get from Unity. Same thing with the stop time. Stop time equals time dot time. Now it should be fairly easy to calculate the minutes. So we make a new variable, called it int minutes dot int equals timer time divided by timer time divided by 60. And we just make that an int. Okay. You can just copy that line and do the same for the seconds. To find the seconds, we have to use the modulo instead of the divide. To calculate the hundredths, it's a little bit more tricky. We still have to make an int, and we call the second hundred int equals 2. And then we have to round it. So we say math floor. And then we have to use the timer time, minus second int plus minus int times 60. And we divide all this by, no, times all this by 100. And always remember the semicolon. We could use the if running statement again. So we just copy it from up above and just delete the content. And now we have to calculate the text field. So timer minutes.text equals 2. Minus.int to string, semicolon. The next one is almost the same. Timer seconds.text equals to seconds int to string. And the last line, of course, is timer seconds 100.text equals to timer seconds int to string. And now we can test in Unity. It looks almost as intended. We can see we are missing a zero in front of the first digit. Yeah, let's fix that. The problem occurs when the number is smaller than 10. So we could actually change this sentence to an if statement. If minus int is less than 10, then timer minutes.text equals to 0 plus minus minutes int, or else minutes int to string. And we can just copy that for the next sentence. And this time it's not minutes, but it's seconds int and seconds int and seconds int. And we do the same thing with the last sentence. Like this. Okay, let's try in Unity again. Oh, not good. I completely screwed up. It's my bad. It has to be 1, 0 instead of 2. Let's test again. Oh, looks beautiful. The digits are working fine now. But it seems there's a problem with the stop timer. Yes. It looked like the stop time has the wrong value. My bad. Stop time equals timer time. And let's have a look. Beautiful, works as intended. That was all, guys. Have a nice day and see you soon to another Unity tutorial. Have fun.